Joining us now in studio, Dr. Robert Murphy, professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. We haven't had you here in person for a while.
I'm back.
Is this a good sign?
This is a very good sign.
But we keep, you know.
We're 6 feet apart now, but
right?
That's okay.
But we're, the fact that we're seeing you in person, but we keep this Omicron variant, I feel like we hear mixed messages, like it's spreading, we're so worried about it, but it's also not as severe as Delta. Tell people.
We don't really know, but apparently, let's face it, it's more transmissible. It's beating Delta. You know, we had two cases yesterday, one case 2 days before that. Today we have 10, you know, one, two, 10. That's how it's spreading. You're going to have dozens of cases and hundreds and thousands.
But is it considered as dangerous as the Delta variant?
We don't really know, but anecdotal reports from South Africa, which is loaded with Omicron, is they're reporting very mild symptoms and also symptoms, and these are mostly vaccinated people now that are getting reported. And they're not having the problem with the smelling. It's just anecdotal reports from people who see a lot of patients. So, you know, take it with a grain of salt. But it's really no worse, let's put it that way.
How are the vaccines holding up here? A new study here comparing the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines.
Yeah, the Pfizer and Moderna vaccine were studied in a huge trial with hundreds of over 200,000 in each, taking each of the vaccines, compared them. They work great. If you dig down into the data, the Moderna virus does a little bit better. A vaccine does a little bit better in preventing infection and preventing hospitalization, but at the end of the day, the death rate is about the same. But they both work. Moderna gives a slight edge.
So for people who still are hesitant about the vaccine or the booster, they hear that people are still getting COVID even if they've been vaccinated. Mm-hmm. Explain the importance of that and the booster.
If you look at who ends up in the hospital, it's approximately 10 times more people who are unvaccinated. You go around the hospital ward, it's people that didn't take the vaccine. It's a rare person who has COVID, or you know, only about 10%. You look at the deaths, same thing. Actually, it's about 14 times different. So if you want to live or not end up in the hospital, even getting infection, it's about 5 to 1. 5 times more likely to get it if you're unvaccinated versus vaccinated. Now, hopefully this is going to hold up with the Omicron. And we'll see the same thing. Maybe, you know, people will get a mild infection, like what's being reported now from South Africa in the few cases here in the United States. But boy, this is the time to get vaccinated because this thing is going to spread like crazy.
All right, let's get to some viewer questions here. This is first here. When you say it is not safe for vaccinated and unvaccinated to get together, who is at risk?
Who's at risk are the unvaccinated person is much more likely to be bringing infection into the group so that they are likely to spread it among the vaccinated, because vaccinated people can still get infected. And if somebody has some underlying disease, you have an older grandmother or somebody who's got a chronic leukemia or some underlying medical condition, you know, I mean, this is just not worth the risk. Vaccinated people can hang out in relatively small groups and feel safe.
All right, here's another question. When someone tests positive, how do they know which variant they have?
Well, they don't. That's a difficult test. It's totally doable. All the major universities in town can do it, and state laboratories, a lot of them can do it. You don't know. Right now, it's 99% Delta, so there's no point to do it. You have Delta. But now with the new variant coming, it could be a little bit different. What is happening in the state of Illinois and many other states is they're testing a certain percentage. Nationwide, it used to be about 1%. Now it's up to about 14% of all the samples are being tested to see what variant you have. So you're going to get it more on the population level, not on the individual level.
All right, time for one more here. This person says, I had COVID-19 September 18th of this year and was hospitalized. I was given remdesivir for 3 days. When can I get my booster shot?
Well, you can get it whenever you want. Remdesivir doesn't have anything to do with when you take the booster. As long as you've recovered from the COVID and you're not on any more medications for COVID, you can go ahead and get your booster if you're 6 months after your Moderna or Pfizer vaccine or 2 months after J&J. I think this person may be getting a little confused with the monoclonal antibodies. If they get the monoclonal antibody treatment, which are great, by the way, and can prevent hospitalization and death, you have to wait 90 days.
Well, Dr. Murphy, it's great to see you in person again.
Good
to
see you
again. I'm
glad to be back.
If you didn't get your question answered, the doctor answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or head to our Morning News Facebook page and post one there. We'll talk to him again on Monday. Have a good weekend.
See you Monday.